stand, please, for our introit hymn. Sunday, which is also known as Refreshment Sunday or more commonly Mothering Sunday. And to that end, we have simnel cake and flowers, and I will bless those and they will be given out at the end after the service, so no nibbling during sermons. Heavenly Father, we ask you to bless this simnel cake, that it may be a sign to us of the feeding, love and care that we have received from our earthly mothers, through whom you gave us life, from Holy Mother Church, through whom we are reborn and nurtured in Christ, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Heavenly Father, your Son, Jesus, admired the lilies of the field and taught us to imitate them by trusting in your love. Bless these flowers, accept them as a sweet fragrance, and fill the hearts of those who receive them with your love. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. So the Lord be with you. I am the light of the world, says the Lord. Those who follow me will have the light of life. Let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength. Jesus said, this is the great and first commandment. And a second is like it. You shall love your neighbour as yourself. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And we omit the Gloria during Lent. And so we come to the collect. Gracious God, in order that we, children of the earth, might discern good from evil, you sent your Son to be the light of the world. As the light of Christ shines upon us, may we learn what pleases you and live in truth and goodness through the same Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, you hate nothing that you have made, and you forgive the sins of all who are penitent. Create and make in us new and contrite hearts, that we, worthily lamenting our sins and acknowledging our wretchedness, may obtain of you, the God of all mercy, perfect remission and forgiveness. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We sit for the readings.
The first reading is from 1 Samuel, chapter 16, starting at the first verse. The Lord said to Samuel, how long will you grieve over Saul? I have rejected him from being king over Israel. Fill your horn with oil and set out, and I will send you to Jesse, the Bethlehemite, for I have provided for myself a king among his sons. Samuel said, how can I go? If Saul hears of this, he will kill me. And the Lord said, take a heifer with you, and say, I have come to sacrifice to the Lord. Invite Jesse to the sacrifice, and I will show you what you shall do, and you shall anoint one for me, the one whom I name to you. And Samuel did as the Lord told him, commanded, I should say, and came to Bethlehem. The elders of the city came to meet him trembling and said, "Do you come peaceably?" He said, "Peaceably, I have come to sacrifice to the Lord. Sanctify yourselves and come with me to the sacrifice." And he sanctified Jesse and his sons and invited them to the sacrifice. When they came, he looked on Eliab and thought, "Surely the Lord will anoint him now before the Lord." But the Lord said to Samuel, "Do not look on his appearance or on his height of his stature, because I have rejected him. For the Lord does not see as mortals see. They look on the outward appearance, but the Lord looks on their hearts." Then Jesse called Amminadab and made him pass before Samuel. And he said, "Neither has the Lord chosen this one." Then Jesse made Shammah pass by. And he said, "Neither has the Lord chosen this one." Jesse made seven of his sons pass before Samuel. And Jesse said to Samuel, Samuel said to Jesse, "The Lord has not chosen any of these." And Samuel said to Jesse, "Are all your sons here?" And he said, "There remains yet the youngest, but he's keeping the sheep." And Samuel said to Jesse, "Send and bring him, for we will not sit down until he comes here." He sent and brought him in. Now he was ruddy and had beautiful eyes and was handsome. The Lord said, "Rise and anoint him, for this is the one." Then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the presence of his brothers. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon him mightily, upon David from that day forward. Hear the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm is the 23rd psalm, and the response is, "The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, therefore I can lack nothing. He will make me lie down in green pastures and lead me beside the still waters.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
He will refresh my soul and guide me in right pathways for his name's sake. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me, your rod and your staff comfort me.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
You spread a table before me in the face of those who trouble me. You have anointed my head with oil, and my cup shall be full. Surely your goodness and loving kindness will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The second reading from Ephesians chapter 5, verses 8 to 14. For once you were darkness, but now in the Lord you are light. Live as children of light. For the fruit of the light is found in all that is good and right and true. Try to find out what is pleasing to the Lord. Take no part in unfaithful works of darkness, but instead expose them. For it is shameful even to mention what such people do secretly. But everything exposed by light becomes visible. For everything that becomes visible is light. Therefore it says, "Sleeper, awake, raise from the dead, and Christ will shine on you."
Thanks be to God. We stand now for our gradual hymn.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
I am the light of the world, says the Lord. The one who follows me will have the light of life.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
It's quite a long gospel again this Sunday, so if you'd like to be seated, that would be fine. Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
May my words be in the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Well, we're right in the middle of the season of Lent. And we began with the temptations of Christ himself. And the week before, we'd looked at how symbolism takes such an important role in the time and also in the Gospels. So we looked at the temptations of Christ and saw their symbolism. Excuse me. And then we've looked also to see what it is that Christ was doing in the world, and we've seen progressively that the symbolism of what he is doing is affecting us. We've talked about temptation and the temptation that we have. And we saw Nicodemus, who was, as we described him, willfully obtuse. How come he couldn't see after he had been a teacher of the very thing that he was saying he couldn't understand? So now we come again to a symbolic blindness. This is John writing this. And you have to remember when John wrote. It was towards the end of the first century. So it was a good 60-something years after the events he's talking about. I'm not sure about you, but last week is always difficult. So 60 years. John has been reflecting and praying and teaching. And you'll notice John's gospel is entirely different from the other three. It's much more complex. It's much more spiritual. So what do we have here in this fairly long passage from the gospel? And it's about, firstly, it was about who sinned, this man or his parents, because that was very much an Old Testament view of life, that if something's wrong, you must be the cause of it. You must have sinned. And there are still people, a lot of people, who think, what have I done to deserve this? And the point was, as Jesus said, neither this man nor his parents have sinned. So we go then to the new covenant which Christ is bringing into being, the new agreement between God and man. Now, it seems that it was almost an occupational hazard for the Pharisees to be willfully obtuse. How is it that they couldn't see what was there in front of them? And remember, John is writing this, and it's a different story altogether from what the other Gospels told. John is taking it a symbolic view that he had reflected upon and then looking at the life of Jesus and then bringing it into the fore with his writing. And so the Pharisees were again, just like Nicodemus, they were willfully obtuse. They deliberately couldn't see So all of that is really talking about us as well. How often is it that we just don't see? We don't see what is right in front of us because we've got all these preconceived ideas of what should be in front of us. And in fact, you know, there's a couple of words for that. One of them that we really don't like is called prejudice. And we say, no, I'm not. And of course, we are, all of us. And the other, then, is that we have our own preconceived ideas of how people should behave, and we call that stereotyping. So we've got the two things, really. We've got them, prejudice and stereotyping. They're very similar. Because we say to ourselves, well, that's how somebody should behave. That's how I'd do it. So therefore, that must be, you know, P-plate drivers, oh, look, you get one, you know what they're going to do. P-plate drivers are terrible, they say, but, oh, except for my grandson, he's just got his license, he's wonderful. And so we see exemptions, but we're too ready to see not what is in front of us, but what fits the pattern that we've decided must be followed. And so we have our stereotyping, we have our prejudice. So what do we do about it? What do we do about it? Because it's bred into us. In fact, it's actually a survival mechanism. I mean, we just don't have the emotional energy to be able to interact with every person. So we put them into boxes. You watch on a train. If you're going into Sydney of a morning, you know, not a sound. Everybody's stuck in their own little cone of silence. Because they just don't have the energy. They don't have the emotional energy to reach out. So therefore, it's not a bad thing like that. But what is bad is that we then come across all the exemptions and we don't even look at them necessarily as exemptions. We see that they must fit as well. So therefore, we need to look into ourselves to see whether we are being willfully obtuse, whether we are just ignoring what's there in front of us. And in order to do that, we need help. In which case, it's the Lord that we need to call upon. The Lord that we need to open our eyes. Just as John was saying, open our eyes so that we can see what is actually there in front of us and how we can see each other. And those outside as parts of the body of Christ. Amen. So we stand to affirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is, seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, who was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray then for the world and for the Church.
Holy God, you gave us our mothers, for which we give you joyful thanks. Today, we especially thank you for all that our mothers gave to us from the moment we were born into this amazing life. We remember the love and care they surrounded us with through our early years, the guidance they continued to give as we grew to maturity, the support that they continued to give as many of us became parents ourselves, and the role they played as grandparents, playing such a vital role in society. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Gracious God, we thank you for the role that so many mothers played in introducing us to you and your Son, Jesus Christ, through bedtime prayers and stories, in the way they served as an example of Christian life, in introducing us to public worship in the fellowship of our mother churches and our first spiritual homes. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Creator God, as we watch and read the news, we see the brokenness of our world and that for many families, life is more dangerous than ever before. We pray for healing among the nations, for food where there is hunger, for freedom where there is oppression, for joy where there is pain, that your love will bring peace to all your children. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father God, your Son was born into a human family of Mary and Joseph. Bless all those that we live amongst who are parents and all who care for children in our local communities. Strengthen all families who are living under stress and shine in your love into homes where no human love is found. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving God, we pray for all mothers of children suffering from serious illness. recognizing not only their anguish, but also the way that their love and determination really makes a big difference to chances of recovery. We thank you for the many hours our parents spent caring for us when we were ill, and we thank you too for the many children who grow up to be their parents' carers in later life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Merciful God, like a mother, you gather your people to you as gently as any human mother with their children. Turn to the despair that comes through the parting of death into hope, and may we, through your gentleness, find comfort and restoration in our sadness and loss. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Everlasting God, you alone can see the future, and so we pray to you, who can see ahead of us, asking for your protection for each of us, for our families and those who we love. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Almighty God, you have promised to hear our prayers. Grant that what we have asked in faith, we may by your grace receive through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Whenever you stand praying, forgive if you have anything against anyone, so that your Father also who is in heaven may forgive you your trespasses. Let us pray. We do not presume to come to your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under your table. You are the same Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us. Amen. So for a moment, think of the ways in which we have been willfully obtuse, the ways in which we have failed to see what is right before us. So ask for God's forgiveness. So let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, confident in God's forgiveness. Merciful God, our Maker and our Judge, we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have failed to do. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. We repent and are sorry for all our sins. Father, forgive us. Strengthen us to love and obey you in newness of life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, who has promised forgiveness to all who turn to him in faith, pardon you and set you free from all your sins. Strengthen you in all goodness and keep you in eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We stand for the greeting. We are the body of Christ. The peace of the Lord be always with you. So we'll sing our offertory hymn.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation.
Excuse me.
Through your goodness, we have all our gifts to share. Accept and use our offerings for your glory and for the service of your kingdom. Blessed be God forever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. All glory and honour be yours, always and everywhere, mighty Creator, ever-living God. We give you thanks and praise for your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, who by the power of your Spirit was born of Mary and lived as one of us. He was tempted in every way as we are, yet he did not sin. By his death on the cross and rising to new life, he offered the one true sacrifice for sin and obtained an eternal deliverance for his people. By his grace, we are able to triumph over every evil and to walk in the way of his love. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forevermore praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Merciful God, we thank you for these gifts of your creation. This bread and this wine. And we pray that we who eat and drink them may be partakers of Christ's body and blood. On the night he was betrayed, Jesus took bread. And when he had given you thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. After supper, he took the cup, and again, giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Therefore, we do as our Saviour has commanded. Proclaiming his offering of himself, made once for all upon the cross, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming again, we celebrate with this bread and this cup his one perfect and sufficient sacrifice for the sins of the whole world. Renew us by your Holy Spirit. Unite us in the body of your Son and bring us with all your people into the joy of your eternal kingdom through Jesus Christ, our Lord, with whom and in whom, in the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of never-ending praise. Blessing and honor and glory and power are yours forever and ever. As our Saviour Christ has taught us, we are confident to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. We who are many are one body, for we all share in the one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us your peace. Come, let us take this holy sacrament of the body and blood of the Lord, in remembrance that Christ died for us, and feed on him in our hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Because of the COVID outbreak, we're reminded that in tincting, that is putting your wafer into the wine rather than taking the chalice, is streng verboten. So please, if you don't wish to take the chalice, simply place your hands around it and in spiritual communion, and we will remain safe. Body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. The body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. The body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. Eternal life. The body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. Body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. The body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. Keep you in the body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. Body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. The body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. The body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. The body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. The body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. You in eternal life. The body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. The body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. The body of Christ, body of Christ keep you in eternal life. The body of Christ keep you in eternal life. The body of Christ keep you in eternal life. The body of Christ keep you in eternal life. The body of Christ keep you in eternal life. The body of Christ keep you in eternal life. Keep you in eternal life. The body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. The body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. The body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. Body of Christ, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. The body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. On the bottom of page 143, Father of all, we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, he declared your love, gave us grace, and opened the gate of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We whom the Spirit lights give light to the world. Keep us in this hope that we have grasped, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name. Father, we offer ourselves to you as a living sacrifice through Jesus Christ our Lord. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Christ, our Saviour, draw you to himself that you may find in him crucified a sure ground for faith, a firm support for hope, and the assurance of sins forgiven, and the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen. We stand for our recessional hymn.
And voices who wondrous things hath done, in whom his world rejoices. Hosanna, hath blessed us on our way, countless gift of love, and still is ours today. Bounteous God,
be to thee, O Lord, for this most holy sacrifice. Amen. Don't forget, you've got to give the... Oh, really? No, strang verboten.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Name of Christ. Amen.
over there. Thanks, Jim. You're going to hand it out, right? Okay. And you're going to hand out, right? Okay. Thank you. Thank you, John. Good morning. Good morning. Robert?
How are you?
I'm well. How's that sister of yours going?
She's patchy. She went back to hospital a week or so ago again.
Did she?
The salts go, potassium goes, and yeah.
Good morning. How's things?
Thank you for a lovely service.
It was my pleasure. We'll open the... Yvonne, how are you? Not for me, no. But to all the ladies of childbearing age, you know, whether they've got kids or not.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, they've had kids, yeah.
Yeah. True.
Well done, buddy.
How are you?
Going well.
I might call out Tuesday morning.
Yep, we'll be home.
Right. Yep. Is that somebody's hearing aid battery?
Yeah.
It is. No, we go out that way. There you are.